In our video, Understanding Car Crashes, It's Basic Physics, we define G's as a unit of acceleration and discuss how people in serious car crashes experience very high G's, which can cause injury. So how do we measure G's? Since they are a unit of acceleration, the tools we use to measure them are called accelerometers. Do you remember the definition of acceleration? Acceleration refers to how quickly your velocity changes, and velocity is both speed and direction. So if either changes, you're accelerating. Basically, accelerometers react to accelerations. Accelerometers can be extremely complex, but today we're going to simplify them with a demonstration in this van. These balloons are going to act as our accelerometers as they react to the van accelerating. You can tell they're a little different. Orange one is filled with helium. The blue one is filled with air, which is a mixture of gases, right? Mostly nitrogen, then oxygen, then a little bit of carbon dioxide and other gases. So what do you think is going to happen to the position of each balloon when we, one, hit the gas and accelerate forward, two, hit the brakes and decelerate, and three, travel in a circle at a constant speed? All right, are we ready? Three, two, one, hit it. Cool. And brake. Yeah. All right, let's let them settle. Here we go. All right, let's get up to a constant speed and go in a circle. Wow, look at that. Cool, right? So what did you notice? Did any of the balloon's movements match your predictions? Let's start with our forward acceleration. The air-filled balloon moved backwards. The helium balloon moved forwards. What's up with that? Any guesses? Well, you might say, well, it's because they've got different gases. But why did the different gases make them move in different directions? Give you a hint. Newton's first law of motion. The air in the balloon is a lot heavier, it has more mass, and it's denser than the helium. So if it has more mass, it has more inertia and resists moving. So the air in the balloon, as well as all the air around it in the van, lags behind it as the van moves forward. Now, what about the balloon filled with helium? Why did it move forward? Remember, the air lags behind and gets squished or pressed together. This creates an area of higher pressure towards the back of the van, an area of lower pressure towards the front of the van. So the helium-filled balloon gets pushed by the high pressure towards the low pressure. As we said earlier, both balloons are considered accelerometers, but one of them is better because it also tells us the direction of the acceleration. Which one? Well, do you know the direction of our acceleration when we were speeding up? It was forward, right? In the same direction as our motion. So which balloon moved forward? It's the helium balloon. And when we hit the brakes, the acceleration was in the opposite direction of our motion, so the helium balloon went backwards. When we went around the curve at a constant speed, the helium balloon leaned towards the center of the turn. That was also the direction of our acceleration. All objects in circular motion accelerate towards the center of the circle. Let's look at some other accelerometers. They come in all shapes, sizes, and complexity, but they all have one thing in common. They all react to accelerations. Here are a few from my science classroom. This one is similar to the helium balloon in the van. It's a ping pong ball trying to float in a jar of water. You can also use a cork. My high school students put these together so they can measure the G's while on amusement park rides. This one measures vertical G's. Each red ring would be another G that they would experience while on the ride. This one measures horizontal G's or accelerations, and they would hold this on bumper cars. Now they can make accelerometers super small by using special microchips called microelectromechanical systems, or MEMS. They are so small that they can measure the G's in three different directions at the same time, side to side, front to back, and up and down. It's called three-axis accelerometers, the X, the Y, and the Z axes. Most cell phones have three-axis accelerometers. That's how they know up from down from sideways. Some can determine if you've been in a crash and call 911. Now they can even put a three-axis accelerometer in a physics lab car so we can measure the G's as it races down the track or even crashes into another car, just like the engineers are doing here at the VRC. Accelerometers, including three-axis ones, are used as tools and dummies during crash tests. Over the years, automotive engineers have used accelerometers to help make vehicles safer. Most new cars have at least 50 MEMS. They are essential to the safety systems, like airbags, electronic stability control, and even tire pressure monitoring systems.